Dr A.V. Srinivasan. I am Chairman Board of Research at the Tamil Nadu Dr M.G.R. Medical University, and I am also the Emeritus Professor at the Tamil Nadu Dr M.G.R. Medical University. I superannuated as Professor and Head of the Department, Institute of Neurology, and I have had 50 years of my teaching period entirely in the Madras Medical College. I think the peripheral neuropathy is a concept. People have been concentrating on the brain disorders throughout the country. I think we should focus our interest on the peripheral neuropathy. The reason is, it has been established that in the West, the diabetic neuropathy scores over almost all the other causes. But in our Indian scenario, both Professor Mishra and from Velo, they suggested that in India still the toxic and infective causes, when they did an epidemiological study on the peripheral neuropathy. But slowly but surely, I definitely see the trend of the diabetic neuropathy becoming the foremost, and in fact along with China might become the number one diabetic neuropathy as a etiology for peripheral neuropathy. In terms of etiology of the peripheral neuropathy, I am very fond of saying to people, to teach the students, when you show your hand, you know the etiology of the peripheral neuropathy. The thumb T represents trauma toxic tumor, and index finger represents the infection of bacterial, viral, syphilitic, HIV, etc. And the middle finger representing the metabolic and endocrine causes. Everybody wants to have a diamond ring. D stands for degeneration and demyelination. Disorders can cause peripheral neuropathy. And the little finger or little flow, vasculitic phenomenon causing peripheral neuropathy. And the hand H causes the hereditary neuropathies and nutritional disorders, of which in India, till date, infective and toxic played a more crucial role in the etiological factors. Whereas nowadays, since the age of the Indian population is now reaching 70, and people have identified, especially workers from state of Tamil Nadu, who have done an excellent study on the WHO diabetic study, both Ramachandran, Vijay Vishwanathan, and as well as Morgan Vishwanathan, they are pointing out that the diabetic neuropathy forms the basis for now one of the important causes of peripheral neuropathy. I think the challenges that we face here, I always call it the gaps in our understanding of the neuropathy. Number one, I always call it as the awareness. Awareness among the general public on this is very lacking. People have numbness to start with, and they won't go to a doctor. There is a time delay between the diagnosis and as well as the symptom analysis. I think the physicians must have these watchwords three: A, listen; B, locate; C, look. What I mean by that is, you must listen to the symptoms that the patients give and find out even at the beginning of the story, rather than allowing you to diagnose after 4 to 5 years, in which case much changes would have taken place within the central nervous system pool and as well as in the upper motor neuron. And hence, you should be careful. You locate what are the other neurological signs in the form of motor, sensory, weakness, and as well as the which part of the nervous system being involved. Third is, look for specifically the sensory changes associated with it, which will help us to definitely identify the neuropathy very early. And if it is going to be diabetes, your whole idea should be to prevent the quadripathy. What I mean by quadripathy is, A, the vision should be not affected by the proper treatment; B, the peripheral vascular disease leading to foot amputation, which is in India is very high, you can effectively prevent it; C, the kidney neuropathy, that is nephropathy and neuropathy, they form the quadripathy. And hence, the necessity for causing awareness of these four pathies coming in the patients will go a long way in the implementation of the peripheral neuropathy. Second, regarding the animal data for the effectivity. In India, animal data can only partially explain the clinical symptoms. That is the biggest gap in the peripheral neuropathy analysis. you can't extrapolate it fully to the clinical manifestations. Number three, the physician's role is of a paramount importance. They should be able to identify this problem and start treating them early. The delay results in not getting the enough cure. Number four, most important is in neuropathy, when there is going to be autonomic nervous system involvement, it has got a tremendous amount of the quality of life being affected by this neuropathy of autonomic. A, the early morning penile tumescence, that is the difficulty of impotence coming in very early. Second, there is a constant, what I call it as the BP variation, usually high in the morning and low in the evening. When that is lost, that is the beginning story of a peripheral neuropathy, and people identify it. And third is the blood pressure. This is a point which I wanted to highlight. Please ask the patient to take it very carefully in the nights, the blood pressure. If your blood pressure falls and rises in the morning, the neuropathy patients can develop some neurological symptoms. Hence, one should be very, very careful in the blood pressure management. So, experimentally and the treatment wise and the identification of the other causes and the sheer extrapolation from the animal data, all these things are all gaps in our understanding, and a perfect epidemiological and prevalence studies are mandatory to come to every meaningful conclusion in the management. No, we have not yet got the guidelines and protocol, but we have initiated that process, but still it goes a long way for the problem, because we have to identify first the prevalence and the incidence. And second, we should have a center of excellence. People are doing it in isolated incidences. There should be a complete, what I would call it as a complete coordination between the centers of excellence. Only then the real methodology from India can come, but from the diagnostic angle there are established procedures which we can utilize it here. The treatment breakthroughs, I always call it, peripheral neuropathy produces four symptoms. Number one, pain. Number two, weakness. Number three, wasting. Number four, numbness. In the present state of knowledge, we could give a very meaningful relief from the pain up to 75% to 100% using almost all the three very good drugs. Of course, there are some changes, but people generally use duloxetine, which is very, very good. Two, you could use definitely the pregabalin and as well as gabapentin and amitriptyline. The difference is amitriptyline takes 3 weeks time to take its action, and definitely the gabapentin takes much more longer time, but pregabalin chases, but there are some differences in the approach. Some countries prefer duloxetine, some country prefer pregabalin, but both of them are very useful in the painful procedures. When it comes to the weakness and as well as wasting, we have to have a very long way. I think it is there the physiotherapy and the gait training mechanisms and all the other complementary to our drug therapy will be very useful. Numbness is very difficult to handle, and people strongly believe in the first 6 months you could use it. But the research as it is, because it is encompassing on the other disorders of the general medical disorders, unless you treat the general medical disorders, you are not going to get the relief to the peripheral neuropathy. So, those are the limitations in our present understanding of the therapeutic potentials. But generally, never be the first man to try the drug, nor be the last man to try the drug. Thank you.